Greetings, everyone. This is Mary Beck, president of Seaman Education Association, and I'm bringing with me today in a not-so-live version your contract changes for the 2018-2019 school year. This is a tentative agreement between us as your bargaining unit and the Seaman Board of Education. The first thing that we'll talk about is salary and pay. Of course, that's one we're always thinking about. We have reached agreement tentatively to increase summer school pay from $25 an hour to $30 an hour. And if you participated as a teacher, you have already probably seen that benefit for this past summer. We also agreed to step and lateral movement for those of you who are eligible to do so. If you are eligible to do so, please make sure that you've got your paperwork done for Kathy at the SEC and make sure that you've got that all taken care of. If you're not sure, make sure you check with your building PD person so that they can look that up for you. We've also tentatively agreed to add $2,000 to each cell across the entire salary schedule. If you are in the top cell, which is MA plus 45, you will also receive a $1,000 extra, and you must be there at least into your second consecutive year. So if this is your first year, you won't receive it yet, but you will after your second year in that cell. Insurance. The board agreed to adding an additional $50 a month to the district paid portion. So that brings their portion for a insurance policy to $400 a month. Inclement weather policy. This one has changed for us. And now we will have the first inclement weather day not made up. Instead, we will make up days 2 and 3, and then any days after 3 will not be made up unless needed to, according to Kansas law. We did this because we were concerned that if a snow day occurred in the first semester, that class was not made up until, or that day was not made up until the spring semester, and so students weren't even making up the actual class that they had missed in many occasions. So make sure that you look that over. If you have questions over that, the wording is pretty much the same otherwise in the contract. Just these three things will change. Military leave, some wording got cleaned up for that for clarification. So if you are needing to take military leave to go with a spouse or meet a spouse, that sort of thing, you do need to go ahead and make your request. Of course, you know, tell your principal, and then you make your request to the director of human resources and then the superintendent as well. If you have really big questions about that, make sure you just ask Mr. Pierenboom in human resources. Okay, now let's talk about sick and personal leave. This is also a big change. Personal leave is no more, so no longer will we have 2 personal leaves and 10 sick leave days. Instead, every certified staff will start each year with 5 discretionary days and 7 sick days. If you have banked up personal days from last year, those will roll over into sick days for you. And you will start fresh this year with just the 5 discretionary days and 7 sick days. Discretionary means that you can use these days for things like if you'd have an emergency in your home, like a hot water tank break or something like that, and you have to deal with it. That would be a perfectly good reason to use discretionary days. If you have a wedding or something like that coming up and you need to be out of town, you need to let your principal know that you're probably going to need to take your discretionary days to go on that vacation or trip or whatever. You may take 2 days of discretionary leaves consecutively without prior approval. Of course, make sure you let them know, your principal know, that you're going to be gone. That is professional courtesy, and we want you to make sure that you do this because principals have to be responsible for making sure that we have enough substitutes. And if they know several people are going to be out of the building, it's helpful to be able to say, maybe we should look at something else, if that's possible. If you're going to be gone for three or more consecutive discretionary days, you need to make sure that you get building administration approval before you do so. And then if, again, if you know you're going to be gone, let your principal know, even if it is just a day. That is what is expected of you as a professional. Your sick days will still be the same. Those are things when you are sick or if you have a sick child. So if you have questions about that on a personal basis, please make sure you ask myself or Sarah Brinkley or Liz Cremens, or you can ask Mr. Pierenboom as well in Human Resources. Our final thing is supplemental pay, and we added some positions to the supplemental pay list, and we have High School Assistant Scholars Bowl, High School Robotics, High School History Day, High School Department Heads, Middle School Robotics, and Middle School History Day as well. So again, we'll be voting this week. We need to have our voting wrapped up by noon on Thursday. So your building reps will be coming around with a ballot. Please make sure that you vote if you are a certified staff that has been employed during the 27-2018 school year. If you're new to the district, you will get to wait until next year to exercise your right to vote. And remember that Seaman Education Association is your bargaining unit. This is teachers who volunteer their time to work towards making great public schools for every child and for teachers as well. And so if you see one of those team members, make sure you thank them. They spent a lot of time this summer working and looking over data and information and making sure that we were working for the betterment of you as a professional, as well as our district as a great place for kids to go to school. So have a great year, everybody, and enjoy your last few days with each other in collaboration and fellowship. Again, have a great year.